What's not to like? Look at it.
That freaking heat, man.
One of my favorite Chinese food dishes ever. And when I say ever, I mean ever. We're making tomato beef chow mein. And it's quite simple. There's a sauce that we did maybe a year ago, called it the best stir-fry sauce ever, and oh my God, is it good. We're gonna use that today, and tomatoes, and beef, and chow mein. It's freaking fantastic. Oop. Start by making the sauce, and here's what it gets. Couple cloves of garlic. We've talked about a good garlic press. This is a Xylus, the link is in the notes. It's the best one out there. Tablespoon of fresh ginger. Teaspoon of sesame oil, couple tablespoons of rice vinegar, quarter cup of soy sauce, quarter cup of chicken broth, tablespoon of sriracha, couple tablespoons of sugar, and a tablespoon of cornstarch, and we mix. Okay. I don't know if you can hear it, but there's a Catholic middle school, like two houses that way. And sometimes after school, they have like a big drum program. I don't really know what they do. I haven't seen, but it's making Max absolutely insane and out of his mind. He's a perfectionist. He wants everything to sound and look right. And those drums are making him absolutely freaking mad. And I don't mean mad like angry, though that's happening. I mean mad like, you almost can't keep it together. I'm just mentioning it. If you hear it, it's the school kids doing their after school activity. Gotta love kids. Right, Max?
Yeah.
He's not loving it. The beef component can be anything you want, any steak you want. Could be pork if you want it, though it's called tomato beef chow mein. And I'm using short rib because I love short rib because it's so. Kids. You're having fun. Max is not. Let's cut some short rib. Nice and thin against the grain. I put this in the freezer for about 20 minutes to make it easier to cut. And these little bits of fat that are on here, you know, I'm kind of okay with that. As long as it's not too much. We've had this conversation. Fat means flavor. Now we cut our tomatoes. With the drums playing in the background, we'll cut our tomatoes. Just take that little, you know, piece out. You don't need that. And then into little simple wedges. Let's cook. So the noodle component of tomato beef chow mein would generally be chow mein. I thought I had some. I didn't. I went to the store, regular Western supermarket, and they had just had a complete shit selection. So here's what I bought. I bought yakisoba noodles. They're Japanese. They're not Chinese at all, and they look like this, because these are gonna make me happy. That's the noodle that I wanted. I wanted a yellow chow mein egg noodle, that. But they didn't have them, they just had like some crap. So we're gonna use these. We are not gonna use the sauce that comes inside them, the yakisoba sauce. Yakisoba sauce, which is delicious, and I'll throw back in my freezer and maybe use one day. But these only get a couple of minutes in the water, so push our water off to the side, cook over here. We'll open these guys up because they'll just go in almost right at the end because it doesn't take long, only a few minutes. These guys are basically ready and raring to go. So let's go, let's throw the beef on, the tomatoes, we'll get going, the sauce, the noodles, we're there. Okay, so oil first. This is hot. On goes our sliced short rib. And we spread it out because it happens pretty fast. You're gonna see, look, it's about halfway done. I'm gonna add a little bit more oil and then the tomatoes will go on. Love to hear that. Now the beef. Oh, come on you. Separate the pieces of beef so everything cooks. Now our noodles will go in. And in a couple minutes, they'll be ready. I'm so happy about what's happening here. I'm gonna add a little salt. Yes, there's soy sauce in that mix, but it's all gonna be amazing. Look how great. Noodles almost there. Of course, you could do this in a wok or a pan, but I love cooking out here, so here's my home. And when the noodles are ready, pick them up, let them drain a bit, and then in they go. Oops, it was messy. Now we can start to mix them in. And the best part of this whole thing, apart from how great these components are gonna be by themselves, is the sauce. And now's the time to add it, right at the end. And mix. Now I'm gonna add some green onion pieces. And ladies and gentlemen, that is tomato beef chow mein. And a final touch, some finely diced green onion. And ladies and gentlemen, let's freaking eat. What the f*** is going on? Are we at war? Because I think we're at war. And we grab some and put it in your father's favorite rice bowl. My dad loved that bowl. What's not to like? Look at it. I don't have much of his stuff after he died, but I have this. And so now you get some beef, some tomato, some of the noodle. That freaking heat, man. Mm. If there's Chinese comfort food, it's this. With Japanese noodles, but still. Oh my God. Short rib, the tomato, the tang of the tomato, and that sauce, the stir fry sauce, is so like universally useful. Mm. It's just freaking tremendous. Check it out. Check it out, brah. Wow. So. Oh my God. Make it. You don't want to have to do a whole lot at once. Make the sauce today. Have the tomato beef chow mein tomorrow, the next day, the next day. The sauce will sit in your fridge for fine for a week. You'll be fine. All right. Comment, like, subscribe. Thank you for being here. It means an awful lot. I love you guys, honestly.